Julia Roberts is being lauded for her powerful performance in a new film about drug addiction. But despite the critical acclaim, she's missed out on nominations for major awards this season.
Weekend Sunrise movie man Jason Jabba Davis is here. Jabba, what's your verdict on her new film, Ben Is Back?
Good morning, guys. Good morning, everybody. Julia Roberts. Who doesn't love a Julia Roberts film?
I love her.
One of the best actresses on the planet, but no awards attention for her with this film, which is a little bit surprising because she puts in a phenomenal performance as Holly. She's the mum of Ben, who, as the title suggests, is back. He pops back to the family home on Christmas Eve after 2 months in rehab, suggesting that his sponsor has told him that he should come back, spend a bit of time at family. He's been in there for opioid addiction. Holly is a little bit sus. She hides all the medications. Her daughter, Ivy, is like, don't let Ben come back, it's too soon. Things go awry pretty quickly. Let's take a look.
He burns!
I thought you were dead.
Holy fuck!
Oh my God!
I put my family in danger.
This is on you.
If I don't deal with this, then it could be worse next time.
Okay. You go in, pay the man, and get right back out.
Lock the door.
Ooh, I do want to see that again. It is, there's points where it kind of goes to melodrama rather than just dramas, and I didn't cry. I really was right on the precipice of crying. I felt I should be crying in a story like this. Very important story. You know, I think drugs touch a lot of families. It's a heartbreaking, gut-wrenching drama. 3.5 stars, and there's a lot of other competition out there in awards season.
Did they lose a point because you didn't cry or not?
Yeah, you definitely... If you want 4 stars, I've got to cry.
Yeah, okay? That's where you've got to be star is born, right?
Exactly. Thank you. Now, where do you guys stand on fidelity? In marriage is an important thing in our political leaders.
I thought so.
Okay.
Yeah.
Gary Hart, 1987. He's had a separation in his life. He's running to be the Democratic candidate for the election. He's the front runner. Unfortunately, he's had a bit of a dalliance with a young woman by the name of Donna Rice. Hugh Jackman steps into the role to play Gary Hart. His campaign strategists are trying to work out how to spin this. His wife is standing by him, but it all unfolds and his career comes crashing down in the space of 3 weeks. Let's take a look at the front runner.
Gary Hart is the man to beat in 88.
If we hold ourselves to those highest standards, then the voters cannot do otherwise.
Senator, I want to ask you some questions about the woman at your townhouse.
Can you tell us how you know her?
You can't be serious. No one is staying in my home. There's no need for that.
I am serious, sir.
Bit of a shaky start. First 20 minutes, I thought, I'm going to leave this. I'm going to review it after 20 minutes because it's not great. And then it picked up speed and I thought, this is a film that's been overlooked because Vice is very trendy.
Yeah.
You know, it bashes a Republican candidate. This one talks about the fall of a Democratic candidate, so the critics haven't loved it. Hugh is, as usual, sublime. He puts in a fantastic performance, really timely, thought-provoking political drama. 3.5 stars.
When does he not put in a
he's pretty good
performance?
Our
Jackman?
Hugh.
Amazing.
Yeah, absolutely love him.
It's good to see him looking older, too, from a
That's great. So we'll give it a 5. Yeah. Just on that basis. Thanks so much.
Thanks, guys. Cheers.